Hello, church family, and anyone else who may be watching this video. It's going to be a pretty short video tonight. We did not finish in our study here at the church building last week, the section where we were in 1 Corinthians. So I'm not going to have anything new for the video tonight as far as our study. I am going to share a PowerPoint presentation here in just a minute that has the song that I had a video for last week with some additional lyrics. That I hope will be a blessing to you about the resurrection. And so I'll play that in just a minute and then pray. And that's all we will do for the video. So let me go ahead and share my screen. All right, so here's the PowerPoint presentation. Just this video, the song is called Lovingkindness. And again, there are some additional lyrics that I've superimposed on the original video. Just so that you can see those. So here it is.
Let praises now awake the dawn. We'll greet your mercy with a song. Your people stand and sing for all your kindness. You've carried us in faithfulness upon the paths of righteousness. Our gracious King, you've crowned us with your loving kindness. With arms outstretched upon the cross, the greatest gift there ever was of loving kindness. The grave could not defeat our King, who rose in victory now to reign, so we could live and ever sing of loving kindness. Such loving kindness. Your love, oh God, how great!
All right. So that's the video that we got. Actually, now two songs kind of in the queue as far as learning in the next weeks and months. But I hope that's an encouragement to you. And you don't have to sing them on Sunday mornings with us to be blessed by them. So you can add that to your personal listening, as they are very gospel-centered. They remind us of the sufficiency, supremacy, and work of Jesus. So I'm going to go ahead and give you a couple of prayer requests. I am recording this earlier than some of the answers to this, and I'll tell you the reason why. Abigail may be being induced this afternoon. I'm recording this obviously before the afternoon so that I can get it on the internet. And so it's kind of up in the air as to whether I'm going to be at our Bible study this evening, because we may be going up to be with Justin and Abigail and the baby. So that's kind of up in the air right now. So you can be praying for her, even though this is, if you're watching this at 7 o'clock, some of these prayer requests are already answered. But her blood pressure was pretty high today at her doctor's appointment. So they're kind of concerned possibly about preeclampsia. So that's kind of in the next hour is going to be answered. You won't know that obviously until this video's shows, and by then all these things will have happened. But I'll try to keep the church family updated. And then secondly, also in that it's not later in the day, I haven't had a chance, or I tried to contact them but didn't get an answer. But we want to continue to be praying for Phil Smith, as he's had his knee surgery. I saw him and Penny yesterday in the hospital, and he was supposed to come to home today and then immediately start therapy. And I tried to call and didn't get an answer. So I'm not sure exactly the details there, but please be praying for him and for Penny as she cares for him. So those are the two most pertinent announcements as far as prayer. So let me go ahead and pray and lead whoever's watching in prayer. Father, we want to come to you now, and we worship you indeed for your steadfast love that you have given us. That is not dependent on us. It is only dependent on the fact that you have entered into covenant with us by your mercy, that you are steadfast, that you're patient, that your grace never ends, and you love us more than we could comprehend. And so we just rejoice and we worship you for that. It is the basis of our response of gratitude, our obedience, and everything else. We thank you most of all that the most demonstrative demonstration of that is the fact that Jesus lived and died and rose again in our place, so that we can be forgiven and given eternal life and have a new heart and every other salvation benefit. And so we just rejoice and worship you for your loving kindness. And we worship you for the fact that you answer our prayers. And so we give these requests to you, specifically the ones I mentioned for Phil, that you'll help him in his recovery and his physical therapy, range of motion, strength, all of those things, pain levels. Thank you for the success of the surgery. I also want to ask for Abigail and the baby, that you will just protect them and direct their steps, direct the steps of the doctors, everyone else. And thank you that we can trust you in that. Just for all the other needs that are in our church family, various physical things, people traveling, our local and international ministries and missionaries, people who may be having relational difficulties or discouragement or decisions they have to make. Maybe even someone caught up in sin. We just give all of those to you and ask for your grace. And thank you that we can trust you in all of those. And I pray that you'll just have your hand upon our church family. May we grow in discipleship and numbers and love for you and love for each other. Please bless all the things that we have coming up. In your son's name, amen. You can always let me know if you have any prayer requests by text, email, Facebook message, calling, catching me at church, whatever the circumstance is. I can put things on the prayer chain if that's your desire. Only announcements I have are that Communion Sunday is this Sunday, and then we will have our Sunday evening gathering where we are keeping it pretty simple and watching these videos, just worshiping the Lord in that. And then the next week is fellowship dinner. So thanks, everyone. And I do want to mention, again, this doesn't matter unless you catch this video early, because it's on YouTube early. We still will be meeting at 7 o'clock this evening at the church building, whether I'm here or not. So I'll either be here and lead it, or Dale will be leading it. So I wanted to make everyone aware of that, even though the timing may not matter. All right. So I hope to see everyone this Sunday, and I hope you have a great rest of your week. Goodbye.